Earthquakes near and beneath volcanoes alert scientists that magma and volcanic gases may be on the move. This animation represents generalized patterns of seismic and geologic activity at some, but not all, long-dormant stratovolcanoes worldwide during the months and hours leading up to an eruption. We will use an example from Central America to illustrate how volcanic earthquakes are interpreted. These types of volcanoes form where mantle rock, located above the subducting plate, not the subducting plate itself, melts to form magma. Melting of the mantle is facilitated by water released from the oceanic plate. Let's zoom in closer to show how moving magma and volcanic gas and fluids trigger earthquakes as they force their way up through the crust into shallow underground fractures, causing faults to move and cracks to vibrate. Different seismic signatures will reflect varying geologic processes. Sample seismograms include deep, low-frequency earthquakes and/or tremor that occur as magma that formed in the lower crust rises into conduits. These deep events can only be detected by sensitive seismometers. An aseismic zone separates the deep and shallow earthquakes. At shallow levels in the upper crust, common seismic events include high-frequency volcano tectonic or VT earthquakes, shallow low-frequency earthquakes, and hybrid earthquakes just below the summit. Before we focus on the shallower processes, we notice the layers and forces that affect how and where different earthquakes occur. To reorient you, we again cut away the volcano surface to reveal a more detailed view. The crust is separated into an upper brittle seismogenic zone under hydrostatic pressure that has a complex system of fractures and aquifers, and a lower aseismic plastic zone that is subject to lithostatic pore fluid pressure and which shallows dramatically under volcanoes. Along volcanic arcs, magma from previous eruptive episodes cools to 700 to 1,000 degrees Celsius and slowly crystallizes at roughly 6 to 12 kilometers depth. Heat from this magma conducts through the surrounding rock, enlarging the plastic zone. The two zones are separated by a transition of contrasting permeability that prevents concentrated magmatic fluids from escaping upward out of the plastic zone. As the magma reservoir is filled with new magma from below, it becomes pressurized, pushing the crust upward and outward, but may not be enough to rupture the brittle rocks above. This stress change causes distal volcanotectonic earthquakes to occur in the brittle crust at the base of faults near the volcano. Magma tends to rise in pulses. As subsequent intrusions occur, the overlying rock is pushed upward. The increased hydrostatic pressure is transferred long distances and causes earthquakes on distal tectonic faults. A large enough intrusion will cause the transition zone to rupture, expelling stored magmatic fluids. Because pressure above the transition is 2.5 times lower than below, the sudden rupture causes depressurization of deep fluids and results in boiling and generation of low-density magmatic vapor. This process creates low-frequency earthquakes. The rising vapor, mostly steam, may cool as it rises and may not be seen at the surface. After the rupture, mineral precipitation reactions may quickly reseal the transition zone. During a pause between intrusion pulses, the vapor zone can migrate higher into the uppermost part of the volcano. The next intrusion will again be preceded by VT earthquakes and easily ruptures the newly resealed ductal brittle transitions, causing low-frequency earthquakes within the vapor zone beneath the summit. The additional gas pressure may rupture rocks near the surface, causing phreatic explosions. Occasionally, we observe artesian springs issuing from high on the edifice, which may form volcanic mudflows, or lahars. The phreatic explosions are usually accompanied and followed by low-frequency tremor as gases escape. Because this relieves pressure in the aquifers, it results in a sudden drop-off of VT earthquakes on the adjacent faults. After phreatic explosions have bored a pathway nearly to the surface, and magma moves further upward to a depth of 1 to 2 kilometers, hybrid earthquakes begin to occur. This type of earthquake starts with both high and low frequency components, but then quickly become entirely low frequency. The earthquakes are initially fairly irregular in size and spacing. But a day or two before the magma reaches the surface and afterward, the hybrid earthquakes may become identical in size, shape, and spacing, although they still occur at the same depth of 1 to 2 kilometers. The events can occur at rates of many per minute, and sometimes many per second, so-called hybrid tremor, immediately prior to and during magmatic extrusion and eruption. Again, this animation represents a generalized progression of seismic and geologic activity leading to an eruption of some long-dormant stratovolcanoes.